In today's episode of Tips and Tricks Using Mastercam, I am going to show an exciting new development in the stock model operation. In previous versions, cuts made with C-axis lathe toolpaths or true milling toolpaths would not update the lathe stock. Now, in Mastercam 2017, stock awareness has been fully integrated by allowing the stock model operation to update the lathe stock definition. Let me show you how this works. To begin, you can see I have a lathe facing operation using a fixed tool followed by a contour and a drilling operation that both use live tools. Note that while the Mastercam simulator does show the material being cut, if I return to the main screen and move the red insert arrow down the operations tree, you can see that only the lathe facing actually updates the stock definition. If I try to make an ID boring operation, Mastercam gives me a crash warning. Next, I go to the turning tab on the ribbon and look in the utility section. I select stock model, and when the box opens, I click here first to give it a name. Then, I click the stock setup button, and then check the box labeled lathe option, create stock boundary. Once that is done, I go to the source operations branch where I select the toolpaths I want Mastercam to recognize. I click OK, and in a few moments, Mastercam generates a model of my cut stock. This model can be shaded or unshaded using standard commands and can be made visible or invisible the same way as a toolpath. Finally, I will add facing, OD, and ID operations using fixed lathe tools. Note that the stock removed by milling has been sensed and there are no crash warnings or air cutting moves. As you can see, this new integration of stock awareness and update allows you to use many more strategies when programming. Well, that's it for this episode from Cimquest TV and the 2-Minute Tuesdays Mastercam channel. We hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time.